This is a guide for use of ECHELON Flex powered and powered plus staplers used with endopath ECHELON reloads and endopath ECHELON reloads with GST. For further instructions and complete information, please refer to the instructions for use located in the package insert. Nomenclature. Anvil jaw. Reload alignment slot. Cartridge jaw. Cut line, staple line. Knife blade indicator. Rotating knob. Articulation fins. Firing trigger. Red firing trigger lock. Closing trigger. Knife reverse switch. Anvil release button. Battery pack release tab. Manual override access panel. Installing the battery pack. The battery pack may be inserted in either orientation. There is no up or down. An audible click will be heard when the battery pack is inserted fully. Loading the instrument. Tissue thickness should be carefully evaluated prior to using the instrument. Refer to the reload product codes chart for proper reload selection. Verify the reload size matches the instrument size. After ensuring the staple retaining cap is present, insert the reload by sliding it against the bottom of the reload jaw until the reload alignment tab stops in the reload alignment slot of the jaw. Snap the reload securely in place. Remove the staple retaining cap by lifting it straight up. Discard. Observe the surface of the new reload to ensure that no colored drivers are visible and the reload lies flat in the jaw channel. Opening and closing the jaws. Close the jaws of the instrument by squeezing the closing trigger until a click is heard. The audible click indicates that the closing trigger and the jaws are locked. Squeeze the closing trigger while pushing the anvil release button located on the side of the device simultaneously. To open, maintain pressure on the anvil release button while slowly releasing the closing trigger. Articulating. After ensuring the jaws are in the open position, pull back and hold the articulation fin to activate the articulation joint. Apply lateral pressure to the jaws to articulate the device. Release the articulation fin to lock jaws into articulated position. The device is ready to use. Articulation can be achieved four ways: pressing the end effector against the body wall, tissue in the body, a grasper, or hand-assisted, firing the device. While ensuring tissue lies flat and is positioned properly between the jaws with no obstructions, fully close the closing trigger until an audible click is heard. For better compression, hold the jaws in place for 15 seconds after closing and prior to firing. Pull back the red firing trigger to unlock. Then, pull the exposed trigger to fire. The motor action will be heard. When the motor stops, release the firing trigger to automatically return the knife to the home position. Opening the jaws. Ensure the knife is in the home position by doing a visual check of the underside of the reload jaw. Squeeze the closing trigger while simultaneously pushing the anvil release button on the side of the device. Maintain pressure on the anvil release button and slowly release the closing trigger. Stapler lockout. Under certain circumstances, the stapler will lock out. These include instances when no reload or an incorrect or used reload are present. When the instrument locks out, the motor stops. Release the firing trigger and slide the knife reverse switch forward to return the knife to the home position. The instrument can now be removed from the body cavity, opened, and reloaded in order to continue. If the knife reverse switch does not return the knife to the home position and the jaws do not open, first ensure the battery pack is securely installed and the instrument has power. Then try the knife reverse switch again. If the knife still does not return, use the manual override. Manual override system. This is to be used only if the reverse switch does not return the knife blade. Remove the access panel labeled Manual Override on the top of the instrument handle to expose the manual override lever. Apply force to move the lever forward and backward until it can no longer be moved. Note, once the override lever is used, the device becomes non-functional. Reloading the instrument. Push the reload upward using the pad of the thumb to unsnap the reload from the reload jaw. With the instrument in a vertical position and the anvil and reload jaw completely submerged in sterile solution, swish the jaws vigorously. Then, wipe the inside and outside surfaces to clean any unused staples from the instrument. The device is ready to reload. Disposing the battery pack. Following the procedure, disconnect the battery pack and discard it into the normal medical waste stream per institution procedure. Please refer to package instructions for further information.